Hey, it's Ethan with ComTech. I'm here today to demonstrate how to use the T21P, that is the Yealink T21P. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over this help guide. If you do not have this help guide, please go ahead and click the link below. It might be in the description of this video. Grab it because we are literally going to go straight down the sheet. First thing, making and ending a phone call. Pretty straightforward. Simply pick up the handset or press the speakerphone if you want to make a phone call. There is a note there. It's in red. It says no need to dial 1 or 9. So what you're going to do is when you pick up the handset, you're going to dial a 10-digit number, so area code included, and then it'll just dial out. You don't have to grab a line. You don't have to dial 1 or 9. You'll see you actually don't have lines on the phone. We'll go over that in just a minute. Phones work a little bit different than an older style telephone system. Ending a call, just simply hang up the handset or again, press the speakerphone if you're on speakerphone. Redial and instant redial. We'll cover those together. That is this button right here. So the RD button is the one I'm talking about. If you press that, you're actually going to see any number that you have called recently. Feel free, of course, to scroll down through there if you'd like, or if we look at the next line, which is instant redial, you can press the RD button again. If you do that, that will instantly redial the last caller or the last person that you dialed. Hold and park. I cover these together as well. Hold is personal. Park is public. Just remember it that way. It makes it very simple. So if you're on a telephone call and you need to put a caller on hold, these buttons here will actually change to different buttons. We call those soft keys, so they're going to change when you're in the call. One of them will be hold. If you press hold, it's going to put the caller on hold. You go and speak with whoever you need to speak with. Come back, press the hold button again. Now, let's change the scenario a little bit. Park is a public hold. So somebody calls in, says, hey, I would like to speak to Susie. You don't know where Susie's at, but you know the call is for her. What you're going to do is you're going to have, on this phone, you're going to have two parks. So park one and park two. If they're lit up green, that means they're available. Nobody's in those parking slots. So what you're going to do is just simply press the park key. It's going to light up red. The caller's going to hear hold music. You can go find Susie or whoever you need to. Susie can walk over to her phone, press the park 2 button to retrieve the park call, and now that park becomes available. So again, just remember, hold is personal, park is public. Pretty simple. Intercom, if you wanted to check if Susie's in her office and you didn't want to call her extension, let's say she's extension 100, and instead you wanted to go directly into her speakerphone. What you're gonna do is dial *50 and then whatever extension it is. So if that's Susie, it's gonna be *50100 and it's gonna go directly into Susie's speakerphone and you can say, Susie, are you in there? Very similar to the way an old intercom system worked. Transfer and transfer directly to voicemail. If you're on a phone call and you need to transfer, let's just keep using Susie, extension 100. What you're going to do is you're going to hit the TRAN button. When you hit the TRAN button, it is going to give you a dial tone. You'll dial the extension and you'll press the transfer button again. So that's two transfer buttons. You have to hit it one to initiate the transfer and then a second time to finish it. Same type of thing for transfer directly to voicemail. Let's say Susie's not in the office, you know that. There's no reason to make the caller ring her office and hear multiple rings. You want to transfer it directly into Susie's voicemail. On the phone call, you're going to press the TRAN button, you're going to dial 7, and then her extension and transfer. So the 7 in front of the extension is what tells the system, don't ring the person's phone, go directly to voicemail. That's very handy, as I said, if somebody's out of the office or if somebody's in a meeting. Susie's in a meeting, you don't want to ring her phone. Conference, that's if you're on the phone with someone and you want to bring one more person in. Again, that is all of your soft keys right here. So those are going to change. One of them will be CONF, stands for conference. You're going to press it. It's going to give you a dial tone. You'll dial an outside number or an internal extension. When that person answers, you're going to press the conference button again, and you all three will be in the phone call. Check in voicemail remotely. That's really not a big thing anymore. Most people are getting voicemail to email now. But if your office is still doing voicemails on the phone, it's perfectly fine. Dial in to your main number, work with your management to figure out the best way. But you most of the time dial into your main number when you get to the auto attendant, press the star key, and you'll go to the voicemail management system. It'll ask you what extension you are, you type it in, that sort of thing. D&D button. This is probably the biggest call we get. D&D button is right here. It stands for Do Not Disturb. If you press it, you'll notice up here at the top, it says D&D. This means that phone will not ring. You can make phone calls out, but it won't ring when someone tries to dial you. It goes directly to your voicemail. So just be aware of that. If your phone's not ringing and people are swearing that they're calling you, simply go in here and turn off the D&D. Volume is right down here. We call that situational volume, which means whatever your situation currently is, that's what the volume will change. So if you're on a phone call and you can't hear someone, hit the same volume keys as you would right now if you wanted to change your ringer volume or your speaker volume if you're on speaker. To request support, send an email to support@comtechnc or give us a call. There's our main line. One last thing, let's flip over the page, and that is, what are you going to do when you get this new phone? It's sitting there on your desk. Maybe you just came in from a long weekend and management's kind of switched things up on you and got you a new phone system. It's very simple. Simply click the message button. When you click the message button, it's going to ask you for your password. Your password, as of right now, is 1212. And then you're going to hit the pound symbol. It's going to ask you at that time, record your name and then record your greeting. Go ahead and record both of them if you will. Don't skip either one, especially the name, because that's how you're found in the name directory. So go ahead and record those. If you mess up, don't stress. Look down the rest of the page there and it tells you how to change your name and how to change your greeting as well as your voicemail password, which is a good idea because everyone's is default right now. With that though, you have again at the bottom, you also have some more training videos if you need to see these again, and you have our contact information on the front. Thank you for watching.